program in C to display multiplication table of any given number up to 10 terms. Look at this program. Input is 15 and 15 into 1 is 15 and so on up to 10 terms. So write a C program to print a multiplication table of a given number up to 10 terms. Look at this program. No confusion regarding void main or int main and return 0 and etc. Based on your compiler, you make necessary changes. Look at line number 4 is your declaration statement. Look at line number 6, you are reading the input number. Line number 7, printf backslash n. This backslash n can be included at line number 5 itself. Input the number, table to be calculated, there you can use backslash n. And line number 8 is, as we said, is up to 10 terms. J is equal to 1, J less than or equal to 10 and J plus plus. Look at line number 10, your printf statement. %d multiplied by %d is equal to %d. In the position of first %d, the value of n, here it is 15. And second %d is j, 1, 2, 3 up to 10. And third %d, n into j. If your input is 15, 15 into 1, 15 into 2 and so on. And here it is up to 10 terms. If it is up to some x terms, you need to read the value of x and make necessary changes at line number 8. J is equal to 1, J less than or equal to x and J plus plus, and you can write the program. Look at this notation. The multiplication table from 1 to given number. Earlier program is multiplication table of one number up to 10 terms. Here it is multiplication table from 1 to the given number. Here it is 1 to 8. So 1 into 1 and so on, 1 into 10 and like that. 8 into 1, 8 into 2 and so on. So what are the necessary changes to be made? We'll just see the things here. Look at the code. As I told you earlier, instead of void main, you can use int main and return 0 based on your compiler requirements. Look at line number 6, you are reading the table number. And line number 8 is I is equal to 1, I less than or equal to 10 and I plus plus as for 10 terms. And we need table from 1 to the given number. If your input is 8, 1 to 8. So for that we have a loop, line number 10. So this is nested for loops. One loop inside another loop. The loop 8 at line number 8 is an outer for loop. The loop at line number 10 is an inner for loop. So those who are having problem with nested for loops, you go to playlist and you can find a video on nested for loops and you can come back and go through this program. Look at the logic. If j less than or equal to n minus 1 and %d multiplied by %d is equal to %d. So when I is 1, you go inside and j is equal to 1, j less than or equal to n and j plus plus. If the condition is true at line number 12, then the statement at line number 13 will be executed. Otherwise, the statement at line number 15 will be executed. Check out why is it so. We just take a simple example and put the necessary things. Then it will be very clear.